Hello everyone, it's Mary. Welcome back to the channel for another not too shabby design team project. Here's your coupon code Mary10 for 10% off your order. Lots of great stuff that came in the shop recently. This is one of the new releases from Not Too Shabby. It's called Give Thanks, and we're going to have some fun today with a lot of bold color. So I know Thanksgiving has ended, but maybe you have some thank you cards that you need to give out to those that hosted and cooked for you. But until we get into that, I want to show you here. AJ wanted to make an appearance and show you all of his wonderful projects and paintings and drawings that he did. And so I thought I'd share that with you guys. Okay, show us what you got, AJ.
I got Starfire.
Okay.
Robin. Uh-huh. Well, I accidentally did the R backwards.
Okay.
And this is, Aquaman.
Okay.
And this is Cyborg.
Okay. Wait, I like his mask. Is that his mask on there?
Yeah.
Who's this one again?
Starfire.
Awesome. Boy, you're really good at this.
Well, there's nothing on the back, but I have another one to show
you. Okay, there's another one. Show us.
This one, I had to do six in of Superman because he was really too hard, but this one I really like.
Oh, okay. What's the X's?
That means I didn't like them.
You didn't like them?
So.
Oh, this one you really like, though?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And his face is too fat.
Let's use this finger to point.
That one?
Yes, that one.
And on the back.
Oh, my God.
Batman!
What? That is so cool!
I have to do three X's.
Oh, my.
Face.
Okay, so we start off and then we realize we don't like it. So then you go exit and you go to the next one, right? All right, I like it. Thank you so much, everyone, for obliging him. This will make his day very, very happy when he sees that. Okay, so let's get into the card here. I'm going to start with an anti-static powder tool, and I'm going to be using some Bristol Smooth cardstock, I believe. Wait. No, this is watercolor paper because I'm going to be doing some emboss resist and I'm going to be putting a lot of water on this. So I'm stamping out two of the leaves. Now the leaves that come in this little stamp set are different, which I love because it gives you a lot of variety in your card making. Don't overlook the small images in your sets. I think we may do it frequently and there's a lot of spunk that can come from those. So I pulled out these two little leaves and I'm adding this because I'm making a background. So, of course, I stamped them out in VersaFine Claire Nocturne ink, which is my new fave ink, and I am going to pour some clear embossing powder over them. I am not going to color in each of these leaves. I'm actually going to let my oxides do the magic when it comes to that. So I'm going to heat set them so they're ready to go, and I've poured out some, or wiped on, not poured out, wiped on some Distress Oxides to the right here on my slick surface. And then I am just going to pick that up. Now, there are four hands in this video. So as you can see, Adia is assisting me. She loves playing with oxides and she loves seeing all the different dimension and all the different variety you can get. I am going to play oxide roulette one of these days and I am just going to randomly close my eyes and pick out like four oxides and see what I can get because I'm almost fairly confident that I'm probably going to get a cool mix. That's how cool these inks are. So, so I am going to stamp that, just kind of stamp it down on the slick surface and pick up some color. Now, if you put your paper down and kind of wipe it or swipe it across, you're going to get more of a blended look. If you stamp it down or smash it down, you're going to get spots of that color where you want it. And that's what Adia is doing right here. She's kind of moving it around and finding areas that need to be a little bit more green according to our vision and then getting it the way we like it. So next I'm going to stamp out my image. This is two little kids sitting on pumpkins. Could not be any cuter. Love this image. And again, going to heat set that with some clear embossing powder. I skipped the coloring in this video. It did take me a little bit longer to color them up. I used Arteza Real Brush Pens on Bristol Smooth, and this is what I came up with. I really like it. I think it came out fun and really, really vibrant colors I chose. So I was really happy with the end result. And those two are my kids right there, except AJ's hair is much, much curlier. But so they even said it when they saw this, like, oh, that's us. Yes, that's what I love about personalizing your cards. Over here on this background, I am going to put some Nouveau Glaze all over each of the leaves, and it kind of changes the color underneath. Also, it gives something extra, almost looks like embellishments with the leaves. I'm going to stamp out the Give Thanks, the sentiment from the set, and then I am going to use my Color It gel pens. I haven't used these in a while, but the Give Thanks is a very small sentiment, but it is like bubble letters, so you can color them in. And I love that. I really only use my gel pens for small images like that. So I pulled out some fall-like colors. I really like these gel pens. The ones, when I got this, it came with an extra ink tube for each one of these colors. So it's almost like you're getting two sets. Very good price point. I will link it below in case you want to check it out. Hopefully it's the same price. And then here you can see against the light that beautiful shimmer. I picked out glittery fall colors. So the set comes with some glitter, some not. It's a great set. Pulling out some of this Lanvin Christmas Rainbow packet. Are you all proud of me? Because I am really going through this pack. You should be proud of me. I'm making a concerted effort, as you could tell from my last like 10 videos. And here I am just going to pick out some of the fallish colors, and then I'm going to do some layering of that. I had this leaf that I wanted to use up. This is a Distress Oxide leaf as well, cut out. Lots of great companies are selling leaves like this. This one is from Stampin' Up, though, like 10 years ago. But I'm sure you can find something comparable out there. And so I'm just going to have that kind of placed behind my image of my kids. And then I'm just going to put down everything. I pop up the kids and the Give Thanks, and I laid the big leaf flat. And I like that 3D kind of dimension that it gave me. And then I'm just layering up my card. Very simple to do. Nothing too complicated here. And I didn't put any more dimension in it than I already have. I am going to put this on a craft card base because I don't use craft that much. And I thought for fall, this was a good addition. And then just a few little touch-ups here and there with some sparkle pen just to add a little bit of something to the card. I do take out some Nouveau drops, and that's going to go on her little hair ties and her little boots. I'm trying to keep her and him in a fall-like outfit, and this sort of mauve-y purple color is great for that. And that's going to do it for the card. Thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure you head over to Not Too Shabby. Check out the shop. Jamie's got awesome stuff in there. And this new release, it's just amazing. I'm having so much fun with it. So don't forget to do that, and then hit subscribe so you don't miss anything from us in the future. And everything we use will be listed below, and we'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.